Tessa from Mama's Geeky here, and welcome to the Mama's Geeky Show. Hey everyone, and welcome to another episode of the Mama's Geeky Show. I have several reviews for you today, so let's get started. First up is Mr. Jones. Now, Mr. Jones was supposed to come to theaters, but the world went banana pants crazy, and all of that changed. Now it is coming out on digital today. That's right, today, June 19th. You want to check this out. Trust me, it is going to be coming to Blu-ray and DVD later, I believe, the beginning of July. But as of now, you can get it on digital. So be sure to check it out. Honestly, this movie was really good. It really surprised me. It's slow at moments, but wow, is it chillingly relevant today? Now, it is about the past. It is a little bit about Nazi Germany. It's a lot about Stalin. It is, if you have read George Orwell's book, Animal Farm, which I have not, that is basically what this is, but it's the real people's storytelling of it. Mr. Jones is the star. I believe he's the farmer in the book. So it was very interesting. There's a lot of quotes that I heard that kind of chilled me to my core. I was kind of like, oh yeah, we're literally going through that right now. It felt like it feels so extremely relevant. Yes, it's a little all over the place. It's a little disjointed at parts. Definitely slow here and there, but 100% worth a watch. I've watched it twice and I could get through it twice. So if I could get through it twice and not be bored to tears the second time, that shows you that it is worth it. Especially since it was, like I said, a little slow, a little disjointed, but overall really worth it. Really important to watch, it feels like, right now with everything that's going on in this world. In this country, it's important to check it out. There's some, like I said, some chilling quotes in there. But overall, I mean, all of the acting performances were really, really good. I enjoyed it. I thought it was very interesting. Now, like I said, I didn't know the Animal Farm story. So now it's actually prompted me to order the book. So I'm going to read it. So Mr. Jones, out today, June 19th on digital. I believe it is July 3rd for Blu-ray and DVD. So if you want to wait, check it out then, but you know what? You can watch it today. So it's a great weekend movie, great movie night movie. So since we're all stuck at home, might as well watch a movie. Mr. Jones is out today. It's a great, great choice. Next up, speaking of things that are out today, there's two more movies I want to talk about that are out today. Is this crazy? So Dads is out today. It is a documentary, however you prefer to say it. It is on Apple TV Plus, all right? So it is streaming today, as of now, right now. It is directed by Bryce Dallas Howard, and if you watch it, have tissues handy. You guys, this documentary is so great. So she features her father, Ron Howard. She also features her grandfather, Rance Howard. And it's actually, it was all filmed before he passed, and it is dedicated to him, so get ready to cry a little bit there. But it's really good because they take stories of being a father. She brings in celebrities, right? And she asks them, what is it to be a father? Jimmy Fallon says a hero, by the way, because that's how he feels about his dad. Not that's how he feels as a dad. That's how he feels about his dad. We get lots of stories from celebrities, but we also get lots of stories from just other people. There's someone in there, Glenn Henry, I believe is his last name. He is a blogger, a dad blogger, vlogger. So I really connected there with him because that's how I started, was a mom blogger. That's like how I started this. This is crazy. And I hate that term, mom blogger, but that was me. But it was so great to see how he just was a stay-at-home dad and how that evolved. And to see his struggles and that he just put his struggles right out there on the internet. And I mean, hey, that's what a lot of people do nowadays. That's what the internet's for, isn't it? To struggle along with other people. But there's stories like that. There's stories of health scares and stories of just so many different stories of being a father. Of having your own child when you've never had a father. And actually the internet reconnects you to your father. I don't want to give any spoilers because I think each story really is truly special and each story really truly needs to be watched and experienced by the viewer. But gosh, it was so good and there's so much of it and it made me actually, honestly, I watched it first thing in the morning yesterday and I then took the day off to spend with my kids because they even talk about, you know, your kids don't care about this and that. They just want you there. And I've been working hard lately. I've been working a lot lately and it made me kind of go into my own head and think, you know what? I'm going to take the day off. And I'm going to spend it with my kids. I'm going to hang out with my kids. And that's what I did. And we played games and we watched movies and we laughed and we played with toys. And we just had so much fun. And kids are only young once. So take advantage of them now while you can. But Bryce Dallas Howard's Dads on Apple TV Plus. It's so good. I think it's about an hour and a half, and you're just get ready to cry because it's probably going to make you cry. But I'm a sap too, so who knows? But it's worth watching if you are a dad, if you are a mom, if you are a daughter, a son, you know, just if you are a human being, watch it and check it out. It's really heartfelt and very heartwarming and something we need right now. So it's a feel good. And speaking of feeling, it's a great transition, right, guys? Speaking of feeling, out today on Netflix, Feel the Beat. Okay, you guys, this stars Sophia Carson, who you might know from Descendants. She plays Evie, Descendants 1, 2, and 3. She plays Evie. She's the sweetest thing. I have a video of her up here. If you haven't seen that, be sure to check it out. I actually interviewed her several times. I interviewed her for Adventures in Babysitting. And then I've been interviewed here for Descendants 2. And she's the nicest human being. She's so sweet. And in this movie, she plays April. And April is a dancer. Boy, is April a dancer. She's a great dancer. And something happens. I don't want to tell you what. And it kind of messes with her career a little bit, a lot of it. And she's forced to go home to Wisconsin. But then an opportunity presents itself where she can fix her career and write her career. She just has to teach these girls, young girls, dance. Sounds so easy, right? She just has to teach them dance and get them in a competition and get them all the way to nationals. No big deal. But this movie is so much more than that. It is so much more than a dance movie. It is about hope. It is about love. It is about redemption. It is such a heartwarming movie. I really enjoyed it. My daughters and I watched it, and we all loved it. We all thought it was fantastic. Sophia Carson is great. She's a little bit of a mean girl. Just a little weird to see her play since I've met her, and she's literally the sweetest human being on earth. But she's a little bit of a mean girl for a while there, and the kids in it, like usually when you have a movie with an ensemble of kids, it just the acting may or may not be there. It is very hit or miss, right? Right? You guys, I'm not being mean. That's like actually, you know, that's true, right? And but man, all these kids were great. They were fantastic. And plus, since it is a dance movie, you get to see a lot of really fun dance routines and dance performances, which as a dance mom, I thought was a lot of fun. Both my girls are in dance. They are not in competition, however. But it was still fun. A lot of fun to see that, to see these kids just bust a move and just absolutely kill it on the dance floor and off the dance floor. So you have that, like I said, there's a little bit of a love story in there, you know, before she went off to New York City to become a famous Broadway dancer, April broke up with her boyfriend via text. Not cool, April, not cool. You don't break up with someone via text. And, so when she comes back to town, of course she runs into him. And not only that, she has to teach his little sister dance. There's a little bit of stuff about death in there. So if your kids are sensitive to death, you know, someone's mom has died. You don't actually see them die. It's talked about in the past tense. There's, the word crappy at one point, whatever. She says, "You're a crappy teacher." Someone says to her, "Okay, great." And at one point the word wieners is used by a child. They say, "You've left us out here like with our wieners flapping in the wind." Something along those lines. It was hilarious. My girls didn't catch it. I found it funny. Other than that, it's definitely a family movie. I mean, I still consider it a family movie. I think it teaches great life lessons. It's going to teach you to honor your commitments. And it's going to teach you just all sorts of great stuff like love and redemption. I'm telling you, it's fantastic. It is a dance movie, yes, but it is not just another dance movie. Such a great movie. Feel the Beat, starring Sophia Carson. It is out today on Netflix, so be sure to check that out. That's all I have to tell you about three movies out today: Mr. Jones, Dads, and Feel the Beat. All worth checking out. One on digital, one on Apple TV Plus, and one on Netflix. Also, I can't wait to be back next week because I'm going to talk to you guys about Doom Patrol Season 2. I saw the first three episodes, but I can't say anything yet. I'll talk to you about that next week. But yeah, Doom Patrol is coming out next week. So if you don't have HBO Max, get HBO Max. I think it's also on DC Universe. Listen, Doom Patrol, you still have time. Still have time to binge the first season. So do that. And yeah, thanks so much, guys, for taking the time to watch another episode of The Mama's Geeky Show. I'm Tessa Smith, and I'll see you next week. Oh, and P.S. Happy Father's Day to all you dads out there.